Hello students, welcome to another lecture of mechanical vibration. In the last lecture, we have already discussed the addition of two harmonic motions. Now, on the basis of addition of two harmonic motions, let us solve a numerical. So here it is given numerical. That is, a body is subjected to two harmonic motions as given below. The x1 is equal to 15 sine omega t plus pi by 6. And x2 is equal to 8 cos omega t plus pi by 3. So these are the two motions, the simple harmonic motions. We have to find out the what extra motion should be given to the body to bring it into a static equilibrium position. So we have to find out the resultant. Basically, we have to find out the resultant. And if we apply the resultant, the body will be in equilibrium or static equilibrium condition. So let the extra motion be x3, supposed to be the resultant in x3, which can be applied to balance these motions. So this is equal to capital X sine omega t plus phi, where phi is the phase difference, okay. Now this x3 will be added to the x1 and x2, so the system will be in equilibrium position. So x1 plus x2 plus x3 is equal to, we are adding all the values of this. The value of x1 is 15 sine omega t plus pi by 6, 8 cos omega t plus pi by 3. So we are adding all the values, and we have already assumed that the resultant or the static equilibrium condition will be happen while we are taking the effect of x3, or that is the resultant. So the overall motion can be zero. Now the x1 plus x2 plus x3, here we just applied the formula of sine A plus B. You can see the value of A is omega t and the B is pi by 6. So sine A plus B. Similarly, the cos A plus B, and here also the sine A plus B. So the value of sine A plus B, we are applied here the formula sine A into cos B plus cos A into sine B, as well as the formula of cos A into cos B, cos A into cos B minus sine A into sine B, plus the last term, that is sine A into sine B and cos B. So we have already applied the formula. Okay. Now, if the body is in a static equilibrium, so the resultant and the resultant created due to the motions can be equal to zero in equilibrium condition, hence this is equal to zero, and we will get the value and rearrange the equation like this. Now, equate the constants of coefficients of sine omega t and cos omega t from both the side, left hand side and right hand side. So we will get a new thing, that x cos phi is equal to minus 15 cos pi by 6 minus 8 sine pi by 3, as well as x sine phi is minus 15 sine pi by 6 plus 8 cos pi by 3. And while we are simplifying these terms, we will get a value that x cos phi is equal to minus sine under root 3 by 2, and x sine phi is minus 22 by 2. And squaring and adding both the sides, we will get the value of x, that is x square is equal to 11.5 square plus 6.062 square. That is 168.99. It is almost equal to 169, which is the square root of 13. So hence we will get the value of x is 13, and here the angle phi is 23 by 7 root 3. That is 5 sine phi by x cos phi. So we will get the value 1.897, and to find out the angle, you can take inverse. So 10 inverse of this value will get the pi, that is 62.2 degrees or 242.2 degrees. So this is the resultant this is the resultant motion which can be applied on the system. So the system can be in static equilibrium, and either we can apply while we are measuring the angle clockwise, so this value is 62.2 degrees, and for anticlockwise the value is 242.2 degrees. Okay. So this is all about the adding of two motions. This numerical can also be solved with the help of the value of x1 and x2, as we derived the formula previously, that x is equal to under root of x1 plus x2, x1 plus x2 square, x1 square plus x2 square plus twice x1 into x2 into cos of pi. So this is all for today. I hope you understand this solution. So this is okay. Thank you.